Would you like to quickly and easily see everything that happened in your QuickBooks Online account since the beginning? Well, then you should learn about the QuickBooks Online Audit Log. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The audit log is a list of every activity since the account was created. For each activity, the audit log will show what was done, when it was done, how it was done, and most importantly, who did it, which user. And you can even sort this list of activities by user. So how do we open it up? Well, you click the cogwheel, go over to the column of tools, and go down to audit log and click. Now you can see in date order, every last piece of activity that happened from the very beginning of the account until the moment that I'm recording this video. If you scroll all the way down, you can see that there's numbers 1 through 150, which means there are 150 activities here, and I'm only viewing the first few, so we can click next. And then we scroll down, and then you see this is number 151 to 300. Click next. Now, there's no point in going all the way back, because clearly December 6th was the day that I created this account. And the first few hundred activities are all things that happened on the first day that QuickBooks Online physically needs to do to set up everything. So you can see I set up the names of the customers, then as time went on I set up the names of the accounts, and all of this happened back on December 6th. As we scroll up, we go forward in time, and you can see I added some transactions. The date of the transactions were April, but the day that I entered them was here in December, and so on. So you can see the when, the who, the what, the why, and the how for every last bit of activity. The best thing is that you can sort this by user. So if you go to the top and you click the column user and you click the arrow, you can see that the other users like Dave the standard user or Mackie the accountant user, you can see their activity grouped together. These are the two things that Dave did. These are the two things that the accountant user did. And then the system administrator did all the rest. You should usually keep your audit log sort by date changed. So now it's from the earliest down to the latest. And you can click it again and you can have it sorted from the latest to the earliest. If you're looking for changes for a specific customer or vendor name, you can click here and you will see now it sorts it by the customer or vendor name for each transaction. If you click here, you're sorting it by the date of the transaction, not the date that it was entered. You could sort by amount. I don't know how that would help you. Most of the time, you should keep it date changed from earliest till latest. Now, you should know that if the activity on the row that you're looking at is a transaction, you can drill down to get more details about that transaction. For example, here we edited a deposit on December 26th at 8:52 p.m. But for this specific line, because you were editing a transaction, you can click View in the column of history, and you can see all four changes to that one specific transaction. If you click the arrow, you see the bottom one shows you the date and time that it was created. Then click the triangle again and go to the next one. We click the next one, you can see this same transaction was changed on December 14th at 6:43 p.m. And the beautiful thing is that you can see what was changed. And the highlight in yellow is what was changed. I'm going to close the second event change and open the third event change. Now you can see what was changed the third time was amount. So this very same transaction was changed on December 26th, and this is what the amount was changed to. If we scroll over, you can see amount is highlighted. So I collapse the third change and I look at the fourth change to this transaction. The fourth change was changing the amount back to the original $2,500. And if I scroll to the right, you can see that's what's highlighted. So clearly that is what was changed. Close it out. Now there are different ways to see all four changes to this one deposit. You can click compare and you can see all the changes. You can, if you scroll down, you see right here, this was the first change. It was changed to 2501. This was the second change. It was changed back to 2500. And then you could see the custom, nothing was changed here. And then here, this last changed, it was changed back to 2500 and so on. Show changes only. And then you get a list of only the changes. And you can see the date of each change and the time of each change. If you click here, you go back to the original transaction. Close it out, cogwheel, audit log, and that's how you get back to the original display. And of course, once you make the audit log look the way you need it to look, you can export it as an image or PDF file. Very simple. You click this printer icon, and you get a set of choices of how this will export. Of course, cancel. And you can just close this out and go back to the original tab. If you want, you could actually change the way it looks. You could change, you could make this column wider if you want to before you print it out. In fact, you can click the cogwheel and you can remove the any item. You can add the ID and you can remove the user. And if you do that, and then, you know, you click away from it, then you click print, what you'll see is whatever fax or whatever PDF it exports to will look like the way it looks at the moment that you send it to print. So if you removed columns or added columns, that's the way it will look.